Hi, my name is Gift Egwenu and I'm a front-end developer at Passionate People. After this talk, if you'd like to reach out to me, you can find me on Twitter at @LauraGift_ and also my personal website, giftegwenu.com. Today, I'm going to be talking about scaling your e-commerce with Vue Storefront. In this talk, I'll cover how Vue Storefront can help you build more resilient e-commerce applications. First, let's start by looking at the existing problem with building e-commerce platforms. E-commerce platform built with monolithic architecture requires high cost of maintenance and effort expended in development. So how can we leverage modern solutions that will yield quicker results and help solve challenging e-commerce industry problems? This is where Vue Storefront comes into the picture. The fact that it uses an headless architecture allows Vue Storefront to be a very great solution for us. What is Vue Storefront? Vue Storefront is an open source headless progressive web app storefront for your e-commerce with the possibility to connect with any e-commerce backend. So the great thing is that with Vue Storefront, you can connect with any e-commerce platform. So it would now be a front-end PWA for either Shopify, BigCommerce, WooCommerce, depending on the e-commerce platform you decide to use. Vue Storefront is built as a progressive web app and follows a headless approach where the backend is decoupled from the UI and it's also built with modern architecture. Most e-commerce platform heavily relies on PHP or some enterprise level framework, but now we can build with more modern technology. Vue Storefront is built with Vue, Nuxt.js, and Storefront UI, which is a design system for Vue Storefront. What are some of the key features and why should you consider using it? First, it's platform agnostic. Like I said earlier, you can connect as many e-commerce backend as you would like. So if you're going to use Magento, great, you can connect Magento. If you decide to use Shopify, Shopware, or WooCommerce, you can also connect that. So it doesn't really have a designated or a single e-commerce platform. You can leverage as many e-commerce platforms as you would like. It also has PWA support. What this means is that you get 100% offline mode support. You can use your application without internet. It also has a great mobile user experience and native app features, like you can add the application to your home screen and use it as like a native mobile app. It's also open source. It's heavily built by the Vue community, and it also has great community support, which is something people usually look out for when trying to choose a new framework or trying to choose something new to use. And I feel like this is an added advantage for Vue Storefront. Vue Storefront provides shopping experiences like native apps while helping boost site performance and customizations. Let's look at the Vue Storefront architecture. The way the Vue Storefront is built is that no matter what e-commerce backend you decide to use, the frontend would always remain the same without any change. So you can use the frontend with any backend commands of your choice. This diagram here explains it a bit better. On the left, we have the backend platform, which can be either Magento, Shopify, PrestaShop, and we also have a data pump. The job of the data pump is to pump data from the backend to an Elasticsearch data store that then transforms the data into what the frontend can consume. What's the building block of Vue Storefront? There are three major concepts of Vue Storefront, and they all fit together to connect and build a fully configured e-commerce experience that you'd want to use in your applications. The first one is the Vue Storefront core. This acts as a glue for all of the features that allows you to use Vue Storefront to work. It contains all the entry points, it contains the server-side rendered behavior and a lot of build processes and the rest. There is also the modules. The modules are the e-commerce features themselves. So you have in there, you have the carts, you have the wishlist feature, and you also have the catalog feature. And you can decide to use any specific one that you need. You're not bound to use everything. So modules allows you to pick exactly what you would need in your application. And then lastly, teams. You can team and you can customize your storefronts to fit your brand. So there is no limitation on teaming. It is fully customizable. There are currently two teams, the default team and the capybara team right now. And you can decide to either use those or build out your own or extend your own to fit your brand. How can you get started? You can start by using the Vue Storefront CLI. The CLI is available for installation, and you would start by cloning the repo, the original repo on GitHub, and then running the Vue Storefront initialize command. This will help you scaffold a new project. Let's take a look at a quick demo of how you would typically use Vue Storefront. Now, this is a Vue Storefront application running, and you have different features coming from Vue Storefront. You can add things to your wish list. You can add items to your cart. Currently, I have something in my cart. You can check out. So this is the Vue Storefront experience, right? This is where you would connect or integrate your backend e-commerce. So here it could either be Shopify that is handling the experience of checkout, or it could either be Magento. So that's how Vue Storefront works. Vue Storefront Next is a new architecture based on Vue Composition API from Vue 3 and Nuxt. The Vue Storefront team have decided to do a complete rewrite from the previous version to make integration with third-party services seamless and also to help improve developer experience. With Vue Storefront Next, we can even have more supported platforms. So we have now in developer preview mode, Shopify integration. There is also Shopware, Striker, and Commerce too. There is even a wide range of integration that's capable with Vue Storefront, from different e-commerce backend to connection with headless CMS like Storyblock, Contentful, and with different payment integrations like you can use Stripe, Klarna, Apple Pay, or decide to use PayPal. And you even get access to third-party services like Algolia for search and Amazon Alexa if you want to extend the functionality of your e-commerce application. Vue Storefront is a great solution for solving your e-commerce needs. And should you be using it? Why should you use it for your e-commerce projects? I would say yes, because as you can see, it has a lot of features that would really help you extend and help you build out an e-commerce platform with modern architecture. The question here is not why should you use it, is when should you start using it? Over 80 plus projects currently use it in production. To find out more about Vue Storefront, you can check out their website, vuestorefront.io, and also check out different projects using it currently at vuestorefront.io/liveproject. Thank you so much for listening. I hope you learned something, and I hope this would help you understand how Vue Storefront comes into play and help you find a better solution for solving your e-commerce needs. Thank you.